Welcome back to the channel, folks. And yes, the wife and daughter are back from their 4-week trip across the country. And I took a lot of heat for the disaster area, which was our home when they came back. And this video, I'm going to show you, and total impromptu, I think this is hilarious, when she came in from the pool, caught me with the bug assault gun, trying to kill a moth, I flipped the phone on and caught what I think is like the most hilarious video in the world of her trying to repossess this thing. And then, after I show you that clip, we are going to go into how you can start your YouTube channel. Mind you, I'm only about 22,000 subscribers, so I'm not the know-all, be-all authority on this, but I can talk to you from this level perspective versus channels that are already super successful that maybe don't remember as much what it was like being in my shoes. So I'm gonna be able to show you how I got from zero to the 22,000, and then there's great channels out there like Think Media and Nick Nimmin and a bunch of great ones that I've learned from that'll take you to the next level. And no question, a lot of great ideas you can get from them now, but my channel, my video today is gonna help all of you with absolute the nuts and bolts to start your, whether it's an automotive YouTube channel or any YouTube channel, and get it monetized, start making money doing this and having a great time. First, let's roll the intro. Would you rather the moth be dead?
A moth?
No, serious question.
No.
Serious question. Would you rather be the moth be dead or have salt in the house?
I would rather. Wait a minute. That's the same thing.
No. Would you rather the moth be dead?
No. You just have to be the same. I would rather the moth be alive and have no salt in my house. Nice.
You would rather him be alive? In the house, crawling on us while we're sleeping.
That's not what you asked me. You said, would you rather the moth be dead or have salt in the house?
Would you rather walk to work or bring your lunch?
Gone, but not real.
So watch, there's a moth in the house. I have the ability to kill the moth.
And why don't you rub your dirt?
I have the ability to kill the moth with this. Would you rather me kill the moth?
I'm going
to
tell you right
or
now.
Or would you rather the moth be in the house?
I'm going to come across this.
Like a spider monkey?
Sofa table and the couch.
Like a spider monkey? Like a spider monkey?
Exactly. I am.
Like a spider monkey?
100%.
You're tying your hair up because you're ready to go?
No.
You're ready to dance?
You're so stupid.
With the devil in the pale moonlight?
With the devil in the pale moonlight.
What are you doing over there? You're looking for the dead moth I just killed with this?
I clean house for 9 hours because you're a dirty mother.
But I killed the moth. Now we don't have to worry about that thing landing on us tonight.
We close our bedroom door. What is wrong with you?
But it's, I mean, I got it.
There's no justification.
I got it. I got it. I got it.
I'm not laughing anymore. It's cute when I'm in Illinois. It ain't cute
when I'm in Illinois. It ain't cute now, right?
No.
Nope. Nope.
I'm gonna beat you with my
dog. Ow! Oh, come on! Ow! What do you got there? No, don't hide my shit. Don't hide my gun. Do it. Don't. I'll buy another one. I'll buy three more of them. I'll have 20 of them shipped to the house.
I need to pee, seriously.
What'd you do with my gun then?
Because I'm peeing and you're gonna.
You're peeing with my gun?
You're gonna film me peeing.
Are you peeing with my gun? Don't hide it. I will order more, man. You have no idea. Amazon.com. I will have more salt guns delivered to this house that you can hide. There's not enough hiding places.
No, you won't. Go watch for the food.
Give me my gun, because you're going to hide it.
I'm not.
Yeah, no, seriously.
I am totally not going to hide your gun, I promise.
Well, then give it back to me. Then just hand it to me, then. It will be good. Hand it back to me. It will be totally good. No issues. I'll put the duct tape away. I'll put the duct tape away. Just give me back my gun. Give me back
what
my.
Do with the duct tape?
I'm gonna tie you to the freaking lazy boy, man. Give me back my.
We don't have a lazy boy.
I know. Well, I'm gonna duct tape you to this ugly couch you bought. Come on, man.
I hate the couch too. You're too cheap to buy me a new one.
I'm not. Give me my gun back.
Yes, you are. Oh,
all right, let's go. Let's go.
You want to go? No, you want to dance with the
devil in the It's family. In here. I know you hid it in here. It's in here. No, you're out. You're out. You're out. You're
I'm
out.
I'm stronger than you. I'm stronger than you.
You're not stronger than me. You're not stronger than me.
I obviously just, am.
No, you hid it in here. Nope.
Catch that.
Nope. Catch me outside. How about that? You put it outside. Look at I found it. You. I have it. No, I think I'm stupid. Come on, man. I got it. You're not going to get it back either.
I didn't have you go for a little while.
I knew where it was the second you went out there, man.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did. Feet down. Can't have it back. No, you can't have it back.
You should have seen your face. It got very serious.
Yes, because it's mine.
Yes, it is. Put it in is my... yours. It's so yours. You know what's the sad thing is I saw it last night in the office, and I was like, I'm not going to hide it because I trust him.
Yeah.
You broke all the trust.
You broke all the trust.
No, you did.
No, you did. That moth.
You shot that off 9 times in my living room.
After the moth. I don't want to live with a moth. Sorry, I don't want to live with insects.
I don't either, but...
Apparently you do, because you don't want me to kill them.
There is nowhere that you can hide it that I will not find.
Really? I'll see.
That's so nice of you to f*** my house up.
After yeah, it's so nice you tried to hide my gun. Yeah. All right, welcome back. So I hope you enjoyed that little battle of strength and will. I have won. I still have my bug assault gun until she finds it and hides it from me again. But I just thought that was hilarious. Had to share with you all. All right. So let's get started with the content about YouTube channel. So many of you asked for help. So many of you said, look, I've been inspired by watching your channel to create my own channel. Can you help me? And I can try. I mean, it's really hard as the channel grows to be there for everybody, but I'm trying to respond to most, but there's so much more to it. So I thought I'd shoot this video just to get it out there, give it to you all, give you everything straight, clear from my perspective based on the size of my channel. Certainly not an end-all, be-all, know-it-all. I mean, I'm not it. There's so many people with hundreds and hundreds of thousands of subscribers that would probably tell you even better information, but I'm going to tell you the basics based on everything I've learned this past 3 years. So let's get started. First, who should start a YouTube channel? I've got my notes right here, so forgive me for looking back and forth, and your excuses not to. So I believe anyone who loves to create content, if you're rewarded by creating things, you fix up your car, you take it to a show, and people love it, and you're proud of the work you've done, same thing here. So anybody who loves to create, not, you know, I just want to make some money. I like to create. I get a reward out of that. I absolutely do. And next, I've heard some of you say this, but I have a face for radio. I'm too old. I can't afford the equipment. I mean, all this stuff. We'll talk about that more in this video, but I will just tell you, stop with the excuses. Just do it. I'm not Brad Pitt. I don't have all the talent in the world. I'm not going to be doing shows in Vegas anytime soon, but I've got a channel that absolutely keeps growing because of your support, despite all the excuses I have in my own head why I thought this would not have worked originally too. I just turned 50 this past week on the 15th. So look, if I can do this, then you can do this. I don't care if you're 70, I don't care if you're 20, you can do it. If you're 70, you have a lot to share with the people. You got 70 years on this planet, you can share some great stuff with some people that maybe could probably use that information. And if you're 20, you've got that perfect skin, that great face, and you've got all that excitement and vigor that you can go bring to YouTube and people will love it. So it doesn't matter. As you learn experiences, you can share those things with people. So stop the excuses. Next. Why do you want to start a YouTube channel? If it's just for the money, then don't do it. It's because you love to create, help others, provide information, entertain people, then do it. And if the money comes, great. The money will only come if you do it for the right reasons. Next, determine what your channel is going to be about. I spent a bunch of time looking at my older videos, trying to create videos that were like, I think I did tech tutorials, I did tech reviews, they were horrible, and I thought that's what I want to do because I love geeky tech stuff. And then I realized that I love to motivate, inspire, and help people. And I absolutely get reward out of doing that. And I love cars more than anything. So I combined the two, and now I found my groove. But it's taken 3 years to figure it out. You can figure yours out now, so you don't have to go through the same process that I went through. Who's your target audience? Mine? It's muscle car owners. It's car enthusiasts. It's Mopar people, right? You're my audience. People who look for inspiration and motivation to make their lives better. This is my audience. I'm very crystal clear about that. How about this? Why would someone watch your channel? Is it for information or is it for entertainment? Most of us aren't just natural entertainers, so you're probably going to have to start off with information. Information that people want and they want to learn. They want to grow. The human mind always wants to do that. So providing information will get you more people watching than just trying to provide entertainment. The video with the Lamborghinis or the video with the, you know, whatever it is, it's great, but probably they're not going to watch it because there's a million of those out there. They're looking for information that's unique. Unique information they have not seen anywhere else before and don't think they can get anywhere else. Do you believe in or are you passionate about your topic? Certainly I'm passionate about my topic. I was passionate about tech and stuff like that, but it wasn't very exciting. So now I found this and I'm passionate about it. I love it. And the note I got to share with you all, everyone wants to vlog. Everyone wants to be a vlogger. Everyone wants to be Casey Neistat. Casey Neistat always had a rhythm for his videos. So even though it felt very vloggy, that dude was always giving some information out to people, sharing information, sharing stories with people, sharing the success at the end of that story or the resolution. He had it. Watch his video on how to create a great movie or great video. It's really good. And then, so before you go out vlogging, just know people aren't going to watch your vlogs probably at the beginning, unless you're super entertaining. But if you start with information, you're going to be great. And then when you've got a big enough audience, they'll actually watch your vlogs. I have a Ferrari video in my channel that you can go watch. You just scroll down a little bit and you'll see the picture of the Ferrari. I thought it was one of my greatest videos ever. It was a full day of vlogging. It was awesome. 1,400 views. Nobody watched it. I mean, we're in a Ferrari. We're in Beverly Hills. We're going to restaurants and bars. We're having this great time and I videoed it all. Nobody watched the video. It's a vlog. It wasn't like information that would attract people to click if they think they're going to solve a problem in their life if they watch it. So, didn't work. Next, are you committed to this venture? Will you put the time in? Will you respect your audience enough to provide consistent content on a regular basis and well-thought-out content, not just fly-by-night, willy-nilly, put the camera up and just hope the video is going to work out? Are you committed to learn and grow as your channel does? So are you committed to continually get better? Upload what might not be the greatest video and then get better over time and constantly try and improve rather than beat yourself up. And do you have the support of your family? I have the support of my family. They're always supporting me. I take the cameras everywhere I go and they're always willing to be part of my content, support the fact that I'm not in the pool with them right now. I'm up here shooting this video and they understand that and they're supporting me in this because I love doing this. But let's get started. All right. Camera equipment, the beginning camera equipment, you can use your phone. You can totally use your phone, but the audio isn't going to be as good on your phone. So here's the deal. Think of it like this. If you have a blurry video but great audio, people will know what you're talking about. If you have a horrible audio and a perfectly good video, unless they can read lips, they won't know what you're talking about. So always put a little effort in to make sure your audio is good. Be cognizant of the wind blowing. Get an external microphone, something like this Rode Video Micro or Video Mic Wireless Go. Wireless Go, Rode Wireless Go. This thing will work on your iPhone with the right cable when you buy it on Amazon for a couple $100 and get great audio if you're using your phone. Couple cameras I'll share with you all is the Canon G7X Mark II and the Canon G7X Mark III. These are great cameras. One of them has a mic jack. The Mark III has a mic jack, but the autofocus isn't as good. The new Sony ZV-1 is outstanding, but I'll tell you the new, the Canon M50 with the, I think it's 11-22 lens, is around the same price range and you can change the lenses around and it's a phenomenal camera. So look these up. You can put an external mic like the D80 D3 Pro or D3. Both these are great microphones. They're cheaper than the Rode shotgun microphones and they sound just as good. I don't care what anybody says. What about GoPro? You can get this media mod. The audio is still not good. The video is great in some lighting. Some lighting it's not so much. It gets blown out or it'll end up not working in low light. So, and the battery dies like that on the GoPros. So I don't recommend using GoPros, but I think Street Speed 717 uses a GoPro, I believe. And then, but if you go back to Tall Guy Car Reviews and Mr. Organic, they're using the Canon G7Xs. They used to. Now I believe Tall Guy's got a full video crew following them around. So just to give you an idea on the equipment. Next, advanced equipment is the Canon 80D or Canon 90D. These are really reasonable, anywhere from $800 to $1,200 for the 90D, and then just get the 10-18 lens or the Sony A6400 and A6600. The problem is the 10-18 lens, for those, which I'm on right now. This is my Sony A6600. It's almost $1,000 for the lens, and the camera's like $1,200. So, and if you get the 6400, it might be $1,000. So you're still going to hit $2,000 with a microphone. With the Canon 80D, you'll get out for probably $1,000 with the microphone, and it's awesome. And then another $300, $350 for the 10-18 lens, and that's like this big guy right here. This thing is awesome. I love this camera. Shoots great video. Most of my videos are shot with that thing. Next, Rode Wireless Go. I already showed you this. It's a great lavalier mic. Clip it to your shirt, hook it to your camera, and you're going to get great audio. There are some great YouTubers out there. One in particular that I love talks about Dodges, talks about cars, has a Hellcat, all this. But his audio is always really, really rough and raspy, or the wind's blowing and it messes it up. And he could do so much better with a $199 microphone, clip it on there, and he could shoot his videos and sound amazing. Or even a shotgun mic with a dead cat on it is going to help so much and make those videos so much better. So, and by the way, shoot in 1080p, not 4K. 4K is way too big, way too heavy. It'll take you way too long, and nobody's going to appreciate it anyways. Editing. Commit to learning. Watch YouTube tutorials and learn. That's what I did. A little editing goes a long way. iMovie or InShot on your smartphone are great. If you have an iPhone, iMovie. InShot's phenomenal. I use that for all my Instagram stuff, my little square moving images. InShot is outstanding if you just want to edit on your smartphone. But a little editing goes a long way. Little transitions, little intros, things like that. Final Cut Pro 10 versus Adobe Premiere Pro. I believe Final Cut Pro 10, way better. Adobe Premiere, it's hard. It's really hard. I spent 6 months wrestling with it, got okay at it, and then switched to Final Cut Pro after watching some tutorials, and it's just so much easier, but you got to have a Mac. Next, I'm going to put this up on the screen. Determine your flow. You need to know this so you can stay on track on your videos. Here's mine. Whatever yours is doesn't have to be mine, but here's mine as an example. The first minute is my intro. You guys saw that at the beginning of this video. Then you see 30 seconds with my little quote and my logo intro. I like to have my branding out there on every single video as I build my brand. That's 30 seconds, some intro music. I have intro music on the full intro of me talking and the B-roll, and I try to connect those together because you can buy the instrumental music and then tie it right into the full-blown song, and it's a great little flow. Next, the next 3 to 6 minutes is a vlog. Like, I put my wife and I fighting over the gun, and whatever it is, that's something fun that satisfies your need to vlog and share part of your life and get closer with the audience in that way. And then the next 8 to 12 minutes is the main content, like what I'm shooting right now. And then the next one is the outro. Outro is 20 seconds. Do 20 seconds. I always try to share something cool, a little Easter egg at the end, some little outtakes or B-roll or something fun. That way people will start to wait till the end to see what I'm putting at the end. The reason 20 seconds is you can do the end screen with the suggested videos and your little subscribe button with YouTube. And it's a 20-second thing. So that's why I always say 20 seconds. Important tips on length of videos. Of too short of a video won't get any views, and it certainly won't help you get your channel to the 4,000 hours you need to get monetized. So short videos don't, you know, YouTube's not going to like them that much because they can't run a bunch of ads on them. YouTube likes the 8-minute plus now. That's the new rule, 8-minute plus videos. So my suggestion is all your videos should be 8 to 12 minutes. And if you get some really good engagement on them, they'll stay all the way to the end, and that'll help you get that 4,000 hours of watch time. That way you can monetize your channel when you get the 1,000 subscribers. So 8 to 12 minutes I think is really good. As your channel gets bigger, you can go longer if your content's really good. Next. Storyboard your videos. I write them all down in my iPhone, or I type them out on a keynote presentation. That way they're in my head and I can follow those notes before I shoot. Don't just hope you're going to remember everything, because the second you turn on the camera, amnesia sets in. It just is how it is. It's natural for all of us. So storyboard your videos. Write it out first. Shoot to your storyline. So A, B, C, D, E. This is all going to happen in this order, and it'll save you time in editing. Next, some video ideas that I used, 10 things I learned daily driving my scat pack, 235,000 views. I made $1,851 on that video, folks. So copy it, but come up with your own content, obviously, in it. But you can use that same 10 things. The cheap, what did I put here? The 10 cheap must-dos for your Dodge Challenger. That was 81,000 views, folks. I made $839 on that video. And there's a whole bunch more you can see on the screen. But you can go do the CarMax video. That always gets a bunch of views. People hate it because you did it, because everybody does it, but it always gets a ton of views. Taking delivery videos on your cars, always a good hit. And then the 5 things, 6 rings, six things, the 6 mods, the 3 mods you should do your car. Whatever these numbers are, with a good thumbnail, you're going to get a bunch of views. Here's some tips while we round to the end here. Cut your ums and uhs out in your editing. Just cut them out. They make people tune out of your channel. It just is what it is. Speak faster and clearly. Slow, choppy speaking makes you look camera struck. So if you're You're not looking at the actual camera lens. You're looking at the screen. They know you're doing that, and then you're camera struck. They know that you are. Engage with your audience and utilize other social media platforms. I use Instagram, and I've got my TikTok up now. Daughter's helped me with that thing, and start engaging with people where they are in a more personal level. Don't use music as a crutch. Don't over music your video. I mean, make your content so worthwhile that they're engaged without you having to flood with a bunch of music all around you. And don't B-roll them to death. Long sequences of music of you driving will oftentimes lose people unless it's super interesting. So short, 10, 15 second spurts of B-roll with some music, that's totally cool. Next, here's some sites I recommend you use. Fiverr.com will create, you can get a logo created, $20, $30, $40. You can even get a logo intro created, so you don't have to go through all the efforts. They'll make it for you really cheap. Fiverr.com. Artlist.io, artlist.io for music, my favorite. EpidemicSound.com for music, my second favorite. Pixel Film Studios, if you use Final Cut Pro 10 for plugins, transitions, make your videos look really professional. And then Snappa.com for thumbnails or Photoshop. Really simple. Lastly, folks, I'll wrap up with this. I created a Patreon page, not because I'm trying to suck money out of you all, because so many of you have asked for help. Ask for help and support in your lives, in your businesses, everything else. And I can't get back to everybody. Plus, a lot of you want to know, where can I support your channel at? Where can I help just throw something at your channel as appreciation for what you're giving back? So after watching a lot of other tutorials, I created a Patreon page. It's patreon.com/OC Motivator. Don't feel any pressure to go there, but if you need some help in your life, some inspiration, motivation, sign up for the cheapest, the smallest $5 a month thing, and you will get a lot of value out of it, as well as some little promotion that'll help with you. So just check them all out. I'm not going to get too much into it, but just check it out. No pressure, but it's just something else I'm doing. And I just don't want y'all to get all caught up and like I'm trying to push you to do it. But I think it'll help some of you, and some of you may want to take your business, your life to the next level. And I'm there for you. Based on my experience in my life, I've had people offer to help me too. And I figure it's just so expensive out there to get people to do this. I created this so for peanuts, for pennies a day, I can help you all do that. With that said, folks, thank you so much for watching my video. I really appreciate all your support. Couldn't have got here without you. Please like, subscribe, and comment, and I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.